Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to do charts in Numbers. I'm using Numbers 3.0 here, and let's go take a look at how you would create charts. So you've got some charting basics templates here, but let's not use those. Let's go right to just a blank sheet here and just get some sample data in it. So we have a pretty simple set of data here, just some products and the number and inventory. And so let's make sure we set all our headers and footers. So the header column here is going to have the name of the objects, and this will be the title for this column here, and then the data is in here in the body of the table. So it's important to use your headers and footers correctly to get started. And then to create a chart, all we simply need to do is select the table, and we'll use the dot up here to select the entire table, click chart, and then type a chart. And this kind of lends itself to being a pie chart. I'll hit pie chart, and automatically figures out that I want a pie chart of this data here. So it creates a color for each one of the objects. It tells me what each one is: apples, oranges, bananas, pears, peaches, and it puts the percentages in there, because that's usually what you want when you're doing a pie chart. Now we can always click the edit data references here, and it shows us the data here that it's grabbing it from and everything about it. And I can go in and change by selecting, say, less items, for instance, moving this around. But more likely, probably what I want to do is I want to select this entire chart here and change some things about it. Like, for instance, instead of having percentages, I'd rather have the actual data value in there. So let's go in here and change the data value format. We're going to do it under Format Wedges and change it to the actual number. So now we see the actual number that's in there. We're also going to change the labels so we include the data point names so we actually see them. So already this is looking much better. And then in the chart we could take the legend out since we don't need that anymore. So now we have a chart which is kind of what we wanted when we started, just with some modifications. Now there's so many different things you can do to change this chart. You can certainly change the colors and the styles. You can change the type. So for instance, I want to go, instead of a 2D pie chart, let's go to a 3D pie chart right there, and it will change it to 3D, and I can now kind of position the 3D element like that. One of the things you can do with wedges is you can position them apart from the center, so you could break this apart like that. And of course, if you want to rotate the chart, you can do that right here. So there's a lot of different things that you could do. You could dig down into the chart itself and select a single wedge like that, and I can set the distance from center for that single wedge. So this is useful when you want to point out one item of the data apart from the rest. But let's say a pie chart isn't what I wanted. So I'm going to select the entire thing and delete it with the delete key. And I'm going to select this chart, this table here again, and create a chart that's a bar graph, just like that. And note, I can drag this around on the page as much as I want, and I can shrink it as well and resize it many different ways. So once I have this type of chart, there's a lot of different things I can do to it. I can choose a different style, for instance, in here. I can change things about each axis, X and the Y axis right there. I can change tick marks. There's so many different things. You really need to explore for every type of chart all the different things that you can do. And you can customize these just about any different way that you want. Notice also you don't have to have just one column worth of data in here. I can have two columns worth of data, and charts will adjust. So for instance, if I do a standard bar graph, you can see the blue and the green columns represented here. And you can have even more columns than that represented in each bit. Now if your goal is to print out or export the chart without doing that for the table and having that included as well, what you probably want to do is take it off of this first sheet here. I'm going to cut it and create another sheet, and in here just get rid of the default table and paste in the chart. So now you could see that you've got your data here and the chart here. It still updates. They're still connected to each other. If I do a 37 here instead, you can see I go over here and that is increased. So they're still connected just as if they were on the same sheet. That's not a problem. But it's just nice to be able to print this out or show it by itself.